Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be going over how to recreate this dimensioned isometric drawing in SketchUp. The first thing that I want to do is make sure that my units are set up correctly. So if I look at this, it kind of looks like it might be in centimeters. So I'm going to go to Window. Model info, come down to units. If you're doing any sort of metric unit, you need to make sure you're in decimal. And you can see here, centimeters are selected. And then I'm going to hit X. So your plan of action is important when you're doing something like this, because most of the time they're not going to give you more dimensions than you need. They're going to give you the minimum amount of dimensions. It helps with clutter. And so you sort of have to have an attack plan for what you want to do. So what I want to do is make a rectangular prism and then sort of start to cut away from that. So you can see our max dimension here is a 26. And then this is 7 plus 39 plus 7, which is 53. And then there is a 21 plus 5, which is 26. So what I'm going to do is hit R for rectangle. And then come over here and make a rectangle that is 53. Comma, you can see down there in the bottom right where I'm typing this, 53 by 26. And then I'm going to go up another 26. So now we have our rectangular prism. So possibly the most defining thing in this model is this cut that goes through. So what we want to do is we want to start off with that cut. So you can see here that this 5 comes across from the top. And then it goes straight down, so we don't have an angle or anything, but we know that this top is 5 and it goes all the way to the bottom. So if I do this, then I'll have the slant here. But we want to make sure that we don't get rid of the 7 here. So what I'm going to do is kind of draw this here. It's come up 16.7.7. See, then I should have a new point somewhere along here. That's right there. Okay. So I'm going to come across. I'm going to come across 7 right now. So 7. So I have this guy right here, right? And then we'll fix this a little bit later. I'm going to go all the way across. So we have this top piece, and now we need to continue this. So I'm going to make this come across, and hit M there for move, and then copy this with Control. So it's 7. Come down here with that blue. We want to make sure we get that blue line to show up. Then, all right, so. And then we're going to continue this line from here to here. Looks like I overextended this line a little bit. So this is symmetrical. So what I'm going to do is take this line. Copying those over, and then I'm going to flip it. Flip along, red direction. Back, and then just have to close this. And I should be able to delete that, yep, because they're in the same plane. You can see that we're starting to get, we have the basic shape of what this is. Now, I'm going to bring this over to 11. And if I try to do this, it's not going to be very nice, because you can see I have this little cut. That's fine, we're just going to get rid of that afterwards. I'm going to go this over, just extend that beyond that. Delete your lines. These are on the same plane, so we're fine with that. Same thing on this side. 11. Oops, 11. Come down 5. The last thing that we want to do is we want to make this cutout here. So if I come down to this line and I go up, wait till it is purple. If that ever happens, there we go. And then I'm going to hit 7. You can see it didn't do anything, and I'm not sure why this happens, but if I take this again and then just go up, well, you can see down on the bottom right, when I get to 7, it sort of snaps. So I can place that right there, and then come up again. I'm going to type in 17, and that works. And then we're 11 on this side, so what I'm going to do is move this. This one shouldn't be a problem. So 11. And then I'm just going to extend this up. Just continue that. And then this is 17 across. Take this. Both of these lines. 17. Okay, so now we have our cutout. Now what I'm actually going to do is make this into a rectangle. And the reason I'm going to do this is because if I was to push this, you can see, watch, it goes in that direction, and this is actually a flat cut. So what I want to do is to make a rectangle, that guy right there. I'm going to make this a group, and then go into this group. I'm going to push it through the object. You see, I'm basically creating a geometry that I want to cut this other shape from. So if I select this, and then I'm going to do intersect faces with selection, you can see that if I delete that, I have these two shapes. So it is coming out angled, and then all I have to do is connect these inner lines. Alternatively, I could have used the rectangle tool, and there you go. And then, you know, at the end, you might want to just check some of your dimensions. So we'll just check here, 16.7, 7, oh, is this 11? No. Make sure this is 5, 11, 21, yep. So everything looks good. So hopefully this helped. If you liked this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.